Now we get on to our subject of the day. If you were all sitting in front of me, I would ask for you to raise your hand to say how many of you, you know about the Anunnaki, or how many of you have had encounters with angelic beings, or how many of you feel like that you have seen a UFO, how many of you feel like you may have been on board a UFO. And these are all things, actually, I would really love to know about all of you. I guess our format doesn't really allow that to happen, but there may be a box on the side where you're able to write in. And, you know, some people have inner plane encounters, some people have outer plane encounters, and some people have both. And today we're going to be talking about both of those, but a lot about the very grounded history of the Anunnaki gods. So we know that throughout history, and particularly in some of the religious traditions, we have encounters that human beings have had with these beings that seem to glow. Some of them seem to have wings, some of them seem not to have wings, some of them seem to be physical where you can touch them, some of them seem to actually be able to turn into just a human man or woman, and at other times they appear to be very large and very giant, which of course has been very confusing for us being left behind now 2,000, 2,500, 3,000 years after most of them have left this planet and are not actively overtly involved with human consciousness and culture, to figure out exactly what our history has been. And it hasn't helped that we've had things like the historical lobotomy that happened by having the Library of Alexandria with its 700,000 documents burned. Imagine the kind of information that was in there about our hidden history and earlier ages of the earth, like Lemuria and Atlantis. So these ancient encounters have gone on. When we look at the Bible, I'm just going to mention a few of them. Of course, we have these angels that visited Abraham. We hear about this in the Old Testament. And what's interesting is these angels appear to be totally human. But somehow Abraham was able to recognize that there was something different about them. They had a presence, or they had a glow to them, but they were able to appear somewhat as men. So, you know, were they taller, or were they the same size? You know, what was the story? We have also stories like, you know, God with a big G that may actually have been God with a little g, meaning one of the Anunnaki gods, telling people like Abraham to find out whether or not Abraham will obey him, to go to the point of testing him by murdering his own son, which is, you know, pretty appalling for poor little Isaac. But of course, this was all a test by the God of the Old Testament, Jehovah, to see whether or not Abraham was totally obedient. Never mind that he probably traumatized his poor child for the rest of his life, but, you know, he obviously, Abraham was willing to be obedient. Then we have things like these angelic messengers that are, we see in the Annunciation, where Mary, the mother of the young girl, is approached and told that basically, even though she's never slept with a man, she's pregnant. And so, of course, the question becomes, how did that happen? Is it something that happened through energy or through spirit, like the Holy Spirit, like we've been taught to believe? Or is it something that actually could have happened, like maybe an abduction where there was some kind of artificial insemination that happened on board a ship? I mean, the truth is, we really don't know the answers to these questions, but they're nonetheless things we get to consider. And of course, it could have been either way, because energy and matter are interchangeable. So maybe it was energetic, like the seeding of the Holy Spirit, or maybe there was a medical procedure that was done, much as people who are taken aboard ships now for abductions and have very cloudy or no memory when they return have experienced.